Oceans, plants, and nature absorb more than half of the carbon dioxide created on Earth. Plants play the most significant function since they are the primary producers of oxygen and absorb CO2, both of which are necessary for human and animal health. If trees can completely filter the air to eliminate all pollutants, then bushes, moss, and other plants that take up carbon dioxide ought to be able to do the same. Even so, the scientists conducted an experiment to determine the air filtering capacities of bitter orange, lemon, laurel, and alcohol. Up to 80 kilograms of CO2 may be absorbed yearly by a mature plant. This was also the projected power of one tree. Although it can seem like a lot, communities with industrial facilities really produce a lot more of this hazardous gas. The average annual production of 36 billion tons of CO2 by human activity has a direct influence on global climate change. Recognizing that in order to solve this issue, more than 500 million trees must be planted in a large territory, physicists and engineers decided to consult science in order to attain zero carbon emissions. They began to actively study the problem and possible solutions because the main goal was to remove and utilize carbon dioxide from the air. They conducted experiments using a variety of materials that may absorb gases. An artificial tree, a novel carbon dioxide absorber, was the study's product. Instead of having branches, leaves, or roots like a typical tree, it has an odd form that makes it resemble an air conditioner. The prototype's main component is a unique polymer resin material that interacts chemically with atmospheric CO2. The resin is submerged in water to initiate a second reaction after it is fully filled with gas. The substance starts to leak gas into the water, allowing an artificial tree to fully absorb CO2 and transform it into a gaseous or solid resource. The prototype was placed on a university rooftop so that students could see it in action for more than a year. According to the device's creator, it functions automatically and only occasionally requires minor adjustments. Speaking at a conference on rapid climate change, however, they first addressed the relevance of artificial trees, to which several audience members objected, asking why they couldn't just grow ordinary, genuine trees in their place. But pulling a plow over with a tractor is no more difficult than using a horse. It is less successful since power trees are better at storing carbon dioxide than wild trees and grow about 1,000 times faster. It is estimated that with merely 100 million installations, the process of excessive carbon dioxide emissions into the environment may be stopped. If we construct twice as many systems, we can experience the so-called negative carbon emission effect, in which more carbon dioxide is absorbed annually than is produced. The excitement this revelation generated prompted other scientists to race to determine the timescale required to return the planet's CO2 balance. The outcome was 50 years, but with 200 million devices in use, even that cautious estimate of time seems doable. Using fake trees in real-world settings was one of the conference's topics of conversation. Experts said that the best places to avoid unfavorable responses from big businesses were in industrial complexes and big cities. Every electrical device ultimately needs maintenance. Specifically, they provided many ways to reverse engineer CO2. Scientists suggested producing synthetic gasoline from gas. This technology has been around for more than 70 years, yet it is still not extensively used or open source. Artificial trees can help tackle the problem of climate change. However, a large number of people need to be made aware of CO2 concerns before the technology is used. The problem with carbon dioxide is that it is invisible, doesn't smell, doesn't harm right away, and is very hard to convince people of. People don't realize that every time they burn a gallon of gasoline, they emit 20 pounds of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere since it is invisible. If states don't compel all businesses to drastically reduce their carbon dioxide emissions, the technology will remain unclaimed for a very long time. The tree is an engineering marvel of sustainability created by scientists who have been investigating ways to store and trap carbon dioxide. According to their estimates, the tree has a 1,000-fold higher potential to absorb carbon than a normal tree. The tree consists of 150 metal discs for the leaves and a metal jar for the trunk. The leaves, or discs, perform all of the labor, much like in a real tree. Every disc has a sorbent substance that releases CO2 in a moist environment and binds it in a dry one. Because of the arid climate of Arizona, the discs may absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere when left outside for 30 to 60 minutes. Once all the discs are collected, a scientist puts them in a container, adds moisture, warms the air around them, and then seals it off. The scientist produces liquid carbon dioxide by extracting, cleaning, and compressing the mixture of CO2 and water vapor in the container. Despite being a prototype, the mechanical tree is the first of its kind to be built commercially. It is theoretically possible to produce a wide range of products from liquid carbon dioxide, such as dry ice and jet fuel. In the future, the product may make its way into cafeterias and research labs. Because it can passively absorb carbon from the wind instead of pushing air through fans or blowers, the mechanical tree is unique and its design is far more affordable. In the future, the design may be optimized to provide enough carbon dioxide and even other gas for industrial processes and new product creation. A lot of products, processes, and manufacturing requires many types of liquids, gases, and chemicals. CO2 is one of them. It can be combined with other chemicals and gases for a diversity of feedstocks to create many new things, or to make current products, materials in the global market. CO2 and other planet-warming gases will become a feedstock for many industries soon. Mechanical trees can facilitate CO2 capture, utilization, and sequestration. Large farms are being planned in many areas consisting of many mechanical trees. The captured CO2 will be turned into new things once it's extracted and transported to chemical facilities. In reality, greenhouse gases are chemical compounds floating in the atmosphere.